Connecting to a GS4 drive via Modbus RTU is really pretty easy. Just make sure parameter 986 is set to Modbus RTU, not BACnet. The Modbus address is what your controller needs it to be, and at the COM settings, match what your controller expects. That's for reading and writing any parameter to the drive. If you want to control the drive via Modbus RTU, then you also need to set the local or the remote source of operation to one of the RS-45 options and the source of the frequency control to one of the RS-45 options. And of course, don't forget to switch to the appropriate mode on the keypad. Let's do a quick example so we can see how all of that fits together. For this demo, instead of using a PLC as our Modbus RTU master, we use this Modbus Poll application, which I got from here. It has a free trial that runs for 10 minutes if you want to try it yourself. Now, this isn't an AutomationDirect product, so please don't call AutomationDirect support team about it. They won't be able to help you with it. To use Modbus Poll, you just go to Connection, Connect. I'm using this USB to serial converter from AutomationDirect, so I need to specify the serial port by selecting that adapter, which is this Silicon Labs one. These are the default COM settings for the drive, so we'll set Modbus Poll to use those. Your controller will probably already have these set to something else, so you'll want to change the drive's default settings to match those using these parameters. Also, make sure RTU is checked, since that's what we'll be using to talk to the drive. Uh-oh, what happened? Well, you can't have two apps using the same USB to serial port adapter, and I have a copy of GS Logic running with monitoring on, so I could see the drive reading PLC analog input 1 and writing it to drive parameter 820, which is a generic buffer register for the PLC to use. But that monitoring function uses the serial port. So let's turn off monitoring and then try to connect to the drive via Modbus Poll. Ah, much better. Which brings up another point. You can't use GS Logic and your controller at the same time on the same Modbus network. There can only be one RTU master on a bus at a time, right? So be sure to keep that in mind. So since the drive's PLC is writing to parameter 820, let's see if Modbus Poll can read that. I see in the GS4 user manual that parameter 820 corresponds to Modbus address 42069 decimal. Now this is important. Notice that the GS4 drive uses the hex address plus 1 Modbus convention for the decimal address. So in Modbus Poll, we go to the display menu and set that option here. Otherwise, all of our addressing in Modbus Poll will be off by 1. So make sure your controller also takes that plus 1 convention into account when talking to the GS4 drive. So under Setup, Read-Write Definition, we just enter a 2069 as a starting address. The 40,000 is assumed. Let's look at a block of 20 addresses and update them once a second. So we told Modbus Poll to start at address 2069. But Modbus Poll actually starts on 10-word boundaries, so it starts at address 2060, which means the address 2069 is down here at the 9th offset. Again, that's parameter 820, which I'll add in this alias column just to remind us. Well, if I reach over and change the potentiometer that I have connected to analog input 1, sure enough, Modbus Poll sees the value the built-in PLC put in parameter 820 and updates it at the 1 second rate we specified. If I go to parameter 821 on the keypad and write to it from Modbus Poll, sure enough, we see the result on the drive. Cool! We can read and write from a remote Modbus RTU master, the Modbus Poll app in this example, which is all we wanted to do. Perfect. So this Modbus Poll application is a great way to independently verify that Modbus RTU communications are working with your GS4 drive. Once you have that working, it should be easy to get your controller up and running over Modbus RTU with the GS4 drive. And all we did to read and write parameters to the drive was make sure we're in RS-45 mode, not BACnet, and set up the serial parameters and the Modbus address to be compatible with our Modbus RTU master. And we also made sure that we only had one RTU master. Given that, we just looked up the address in the manual for the item we wanted to read or write to, and made sure that our controller was using the Modbus base 1 decimal addressing scheme. Now what if we want to run or stop the drive, or change the drive's frequency? To do that, we need to tell the drive to accept remote commands. We'll do that in part 2. Click here to learn more about the GS4 Drive. Click here to learn about Automation Direct's free support options. And click here to subscribe to Automation Direct's YouTube channel so you'll be notified when we post new videos.